Right, I'm going to do a let's play of Project Nomad. It's an old game once again, from the early 2000s. And I picked it up in the bargain bin in Aldi many, many, many years ago. And I played it for as much as I could, and I really enjoyed it. But it seems to be one of those games that nobody knows. And recently I decided to replay it, and I thought I might as well record a let's play of it. I might not finish this game because I never have in the past, actually. When I previously tried to play the single player campaign, I got stuck in a certain quest, in the main quest, and I couldn't proceed. It was basically you had to take a certain flight path, and I never managed to do it correctly. And the game didn't tell me what I was doing wrong, so eventually I just gave up. So I might not be able to actually finish this game, but I'm going to record it, and we'll see how far I get. And just because. Overall, I think it's an enjoyable game, except for the part where I got stuck. Right, so I'm not sure about this invert mouse thing. I'll wait until I start playing to see whether I need it. Everything else is fine. So it has a multiplayer mode, which I never actually tried playing. And I'm going to load in a new game. So there's three possible characters you can play as. You can play as Goliath, John, or Susie, and I'm gonna read this from the good old-fashioned manual because the game never actually says this. But there's John, he's the engineer, an expert in the use of Old Masters Builder technology. His buildings are a mixture of ancient high tech and clever improvisation. He uses the marvels of the artifacts and relies on his skills in dealing with machines and all things technical. Then you've got Goliath the Warrior. This colossus possesses the strongest weapons, but be careful, mastering his technology requires quite a lot of skill. Choose Goliath if you feel ready to take on any challenge. And then there's Susie, the mage. Her buildings are modeled on the flora of the world. Her technology combines elegance with firepower and sparkling energy spells. If you choose Susie, you have a good balance between skill and strength. So, all things considered, I'm going to go with Susie, who has a beautiful belly tattoo, apparently. Going to go with Susie because I'm a girl. And because, judging by the description, it seems like she's the balanced character, a bit of everything, which I like playing.
In the chaos of war, the world was split asunder, and the ancient civilization of the Master Builders came to an end. Today, long after the catastrophe, the old world is but a legend. Those few who survived settled on the drifting ruins of the planet that wander slowly through the endless sea of clouds. They are nomads, restless adventurers seeking their fate. They came from the grey market. Three friends, nomads, adventurers, Susie, Goliath, and John. They were far and away the best when it came to difficult missions. The old cutthroat Trevain had told them of a mysterious island in the territory of the Sentinels. Heavily guarded and extremely dangerous. However, rich rewards beckoned, a cache of Master Builders' artifacts. With this, the three adventurers would be comfortable for the rest of their days, although Trevain would, of course, take his usual cut of the haul. All went according to plan until suddenly a wing of fighters emerged from the clouds. They didn't stand a chance. Two of the friends were captured immediately by the Sentinels. One was left for dead when his aircraft, followed by the fighter wing, crashed into the rocks of a lonely island.
Here it is. That's me, Susie. All right. Yeah, this works. Bear with me, because there will be a learning curve involving the, buttons and things. Let's go check.
What happened? Who woke me up? I was incarcerated here by the Sentinels. At last, I am free again. In return, I shall reward you richly. Follow me.
So yeah, this is the start of the storyline, and at the same point, a quick tutorial. So, running is just the regular WASD keys, or actually you can use the arrow keys to do the same, which is interesting. Also, bringing up the menu isn't the escape key, it is the F1 key. So, like I said, I might have to puzzle around to find the correct buttons for everything, but I do have a quick reference card with the game.
Together, we shall transform this flying island into a powerful battleship. Then we'll free your friends from the clutches of the Sentinels. For it's too late. The Sentinels shall feel my wrath for what they have done to me. This is your lighthouse. If it is destroyed, you are lost. These are the magic artifacts of the Master Builders. Crystals hold the knowledge of the ancients. Nothing in the world is more precious. Use them wisely and with forethought. When you pick up an artifact, it is stored in your belt. There is room in your belt for 3 artifacts. Walk over an artifact to pick it up.
All I can think of it is Master Builder Talk is the Lego movie. But yeah, so this is the lighthouse, a very important building. If it gets destroyed, like he said, it's basically game over. So that's not good. And that is an artifact we can pick up.
Very good. This artifact creates a watchtower. Activate the artifact. Unleash its dormant powers.
So we will activate it. You just, as you can see, it's down there in my belt. You just left click. It comes up. And left click again to place it somewhere. This watchtower can only be placed in this particular area, so that's where we'll put it. Just left click again to confirm. So there, this is part strategy, part shooter-ish game. It combines a lot of things.
Very good. Use the watchtower to move your island. In the watchtower, you can choose navigation points and head for them.
So yeah, we have basically turned this floating island into a ship. And soon we will be turning it into a battleship. So for using it, you just go near the building, left click, and you can use or repair. I'm gonna use it. And at the moment, there's only one navigation point available. So left click takes us there. Every character has its own look of buildings, so this looks all a bit organic and frilly. The Goliath has a very robotic, modern, lasery look, and the John character is more steampunk. So it's fun to just replay and see what everything looks like, I guess. I don't think there's any other major differences.
Very good. This artifact holds a powerful gun turret. Use the gun turrets to defend your island. Every building needs energy. Without energy, you are helpless. Collect these energy spheres. Destroy the attackers.
Right, and this is the tutorial on how to man your buildings and shoot things, which I'm not great at, but I'm not the worst at this one. As soon as it's built, you can man it by pressing the tab key. And my building is getting demolished. Problem is that to repair it, I need to get close enough. You can also go near the building, press the left button to use. Yeah, this happens every time.
Try it once again. When a building is destroyed, its magic artifact is left behind. Use the artifact to rebuild a building.
I don't know if this is part of the actual tutorial, because this has happened to me every single time I try this. I don't know if it's because I suck, because this is how it's designed. But let's try that again.
Destroy the attackers!
Right on. Doesn't matter, you don't take damage from things like that. Second one. Oh, I thought it was bad. See, my building seems to take a lot less damage this time, so I'm thinking maybe it's a requirement to fail the first time. I know my island's under attack. So you can basically only hit the things. I'm gonna repair this again. If they've got that orange thing. If that doesn't pop up, then there's no point in shooting. They're too far away and you won't hit them anyway. But I'm doing really poorly, aren't I? It's annoying, I can't see them that well. There we are, finally.
Very good.
Not really.
Here's a reward for you.
Thank you.
Destroy your enemy's buildings to capture new artifacts. Remember, all your weapons and vehicles are at your direct disposal. Now it is time. Off we go to the gray market. We have a lot to do, Nomad. You can fit further equipment to your island at the gray market.
Right. So, I don't think this needs repairing now. Canceling is just right-clicking. Also, we've got a little jetpack, which is pretty cool. You can just jump as if, or if you run and you jump a bit further, and let's go check out, ooh, actually let's build a second gun tower first. I want one in the front and one in the back. Maybe there. That's like opposites. Right? So tab will automatically put us into them and swap between them. And right clicking takes us back to control of character. So let's use our watchtower to go to the grey market.
The Grey Market. Trevain, an old nomad, had settled down there after his many travels. Since then, he'd made a living out of trading artifacts. For the right price, one could get everything there, or lose everything. However, the once bustling market was now a sorry sight, gloomy and bare.
Alright, so we're at the Grey Market. Let's go visit Trevain, the guy who sent us out in the first place, I believe. Go a bit faster. Oh shit. While you can't fall off edges if you run, the character will stop. You can actually jump off edges. So, careful where to use the jetpack. There he is. Shall we go talk to him? Let's have a little chat. That's why we're here after all.
You. What have you done? The Sentinels have set up a blockade around the market and are preparing to attack. We don't stand a chance against the Sentinels' fleet. We're done for. This is all your fault, you wretched master builder. Greetings, noble sir. It is a long time since I saw one of your guild. I would help you, but the Sentinels...
We'll help you, Trevain. We'll break the power of the Sentinels. There is only one solution. The power of the Sentinels must be broken. You must face their leader, Seraphim, and destroy his citadel. With my help, you'll succeed in freeing your friends from Seraphim's clutches.
Thank you, noble sir. Nomad, to infiltrate the realm of the Sentinels, you must go through the Pirate's Ravine. From there, you'll have to fight your way through to Athenor. But first, take a good look around. Take what you need from my cache of artifacts. Equip your island well, otherwise, you won't stand a chance. You'll have to find an aircraft hangar yourself. We'll talk about the payment later.
You're completely on your own. Nobody knows what awaits you in the Pirate's Ravine. Use the power of the artifacts wisely and with forethought, Nomad. Then you will succeed. Good luck, Nomad. I'll be waiting for you here.
Awesome. So we're on our own, eh? We've got a new nav point, the one towards the Pirate's Ravine. Let's pick up this first. I wonder what it is. I'll go build it too. There's some pretty cool things to discover here, and I think we'll come back here later anyway. But let's have a look around. Try not to die. Can we go up here? Yes, we can. Oh. Yeah, sorry for my wobbly.
When your belt
controls.
Is full, you can store artifacts in the artifact safe.
Yeah, so if we've got too many artifacts and we can't build them, or we can't do any, or we don't want to build with them, then we can store them in a safe, if we have one available, of course. So you see that tower with the red light on top there? That's sort of the style that Goliath has in his buildings. Getting myself stuck here. Look at that, shadow and everything. Advanced graphics. And getting myself stuck again. Yeah, maybe I do need to invert the mouse. I'm not sure yet. It seems fairly okay. There's nothing here, is there? Nope, nothing. Came here for no reason. Just having a look. Crashed plane. No, you see, it's a bit annoying that the character running doesn't seem to be very realistic. But at the same time, at least she's running fast. Because there's a lot of running.
The artifact press is used to enhance artifacts. Unfortunately, all the combinations have been lost.
Now, I read a bit in the manual. And it says here, what does it say? Artifact press. Let me just. Ah. Right. For example, you can use 2 first great gun tower artifacts to make 1 second great gun tower artifact. So I don't know if I want to do that. Also, do you see this red gun turret? That is an artifact that when I build that gun turret, if it gets destroyed, it's gone forever. So it won't actually just leave an artifact behind that I can rebuild. So all the blue ones I can rebuild infinitely. The red ones, once destroyed, are gone. Which is okay for a gun turret, I don't care too much about that. And apparently, according to the manual, if you combine a blue artifact with a red artifact, the resulting artifact will be a red one. So, best not to do that, actually, because you'd permanently lose it. So, better to wait until you have 2 blue ones. Now, I'm going to just move here. Out of the way of everything I have and build my things. Now this butterfly thing seems to be a power plant and this is a gun tower. So let's place my power plant somewhere in the middle of my island, because we want to keep it protected. We don't want to have that destroyed. How pretty is that? Oh. And what I might do is I might actually blow up my 2 gun turrets and create 1 better one. Or should I leave it? I don't know. I could try. I've never done this actually. Let's blow it up. There we are. Ooh, and let's build the red one in the back. I don't know which is the front or the back of my island. Let's assume this is the back. So that is a destructible one. I'll destroy the other blue one I've got and we'll create 1 new super one. There we go. If you fail to create a new artifact, it's not too terrible. You keep the two ones that you tried to combine still, so they're not lost if you put them in there to try a combination. So you can try out pretty much anything if you'd like. But let's make something. Use Gun Tower 1 and Gun Tower 2. Success! So I've got a better gun tower now, I assume. Let's go put it on my island somewhere. Well, I know where. The opposite of the other one. Right. And bum bum bum. Yeah, there. Right, let's have a look at it. It's got two shooty things on it. Gun barrels. Cool. So let's go back to exploring. I think the blue bar is my backpack energy, or my, if I'm on my island, it's my island energy, which you need to build and repair items. You can't infinitely repair during battle. Outside of battle, I think your energy replenishes. So this is gonna be great, right? So I don't think I can make that jump. But what I can do is pick up this, which is kind of interesting. Ooh, I can see an artifact on the top of that mountain there. So, what we want to do is, I'm going to save. And, pick up those energy things and then fly up to the top of that mountain, because my backpack is now a proper jetpack. This is going to hurt. Oh, that wasn't too bad. Oh, this is steering very weirdly. Oh wow. So we made it, and we didn't die. Awesome. What did we pick up? I have no idea what that is. And just, ooh, a silo. Store energy, so my island can have more energy on it, apparently, is what it is. Oh, wait, where's my second gun turret? I don't see it. Never mind, I'm sure it's there. Let's put it here. It was hidden by the light thing. Oh, isn't that pretty? Can only repair or destroy it. So, I can now fly a little bit. Later on, we get even better stuff. It does mean, I think, that... Yeah, I can still use it as a jumpy backpack too. Cool. Eventually that flying will wear out and you'll have to find another one of the backpack upgradey things. But I think I've got everything that's here, although I could be wrong. I haven't really been everywhere, I think. Maybe I have. Let's assume I have everything. See if we can talk to our non-friends. They're more like employers. I don't know if I can fly there, and if I can, whether there's anything to grab the with everything that you can fly with, like your backpack, or later you can get like a little little airplane. There's only a certain distance you can go from your own island. If you go too far, you crash and die. Let's see. Can't talk to you. No. Yes, I know my belt is empty. Right. So, I guess it's off to the pirate place. Running in this game. Right, watchtower. I'm gonna save. I know I just saved, but it's just because I'm going on a start my quest. So once again, we only have one nav point here, so off we go. Okay, so that's the front. So our biggest gun turret is at the front. Good to know.